Welcome back to Let's Play Tear of Vermillion. A Tear of Vermillion. The Legend of Heroes. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now entering Quitt. 160 Milos is this long. Okay. Oh. This is Quitt. It looks pretty quiet. Well, they just left out the I and added extra T, you know how it is. Rutu says, this village is quite rich, I hear. They say that gold dust is collected in Moss Lake in the south. Douglas says, the gold is also a famous trading good that has a stable value. I heard that the way to collect it is quite unique. Unique? Says Avon. I don't know any details, though. Well, we are here to look for the sacred treasure. I don't care about gold. Rutu says, Scotia of beautiful water. The Scosa shrine should be somewhere close. Let's check inside the village. Let's! Hello, old codger. Tool shop owner says, sorry, but come to the front of the counter. So picky. Hi, welcome. We've got some convenient items. Alright. I never buy these things because I pretty much find them by myself. Royal powder. Used by the royal family, awakens unconscious while fully restoring power. Let's hold off on that. Circle charm? Talisman containing oxide circle inside gives neutral damage to an enemy. Deathquake? Quake charm is Deathquake. Gives earth damage to the surrounding. A moon ring. Symbolizes the mysterious power of the moon. Enhances the wearer's spell power. Hermit boots. It all comes with negative effects. Forest cape, yeah, we're familiar with that. Crystals, fire, water, and there's pet foods. I may or may not come again. Probably not. Let's see if he... Oh, I can't... Wait a second. I want to go around so him tell me to go around the... to the other side of the counter. This side is private. Can you come around to our shop? No, I'm gonna like poke around your belongings. Welcome. Ask me anything about the weapons and protections. The weapons and protections, huh? Oh, Luna Blade. Look at that. Increases Avon by 21, wow. That's good for Douglas, too. Can... Alright, we have to do the exchange. I have to see how much money I have. I'm sure... Oh, we got plenty now. Wow. Okay. We've also got a dagger. A dark. Tatar for Rutis. 2100. Round shield. Rick shield. Shield designed for sheer performance, favored by veteran adventurers. A knight shield. Adopted by the royal chevaliers. How's that? Ease of use and protection guaranteed. Well, that's good for routines. We've seen this before, I think. Yeah. Half plate. Scale mail. Routines. I don't know if I can afford all this. And for Douglas. Brings down Avon's magic defense. Alright, let's get these Luna blades. Yeah. Okay, we got Luna, two Luna Blades. And a Katar. We'll get a Katar for Rutis. Longer sword mainly used in Deuces. Double edge with a leaf shaped blade. Imagine attacking someone with a blade that looks like a leaf. Alright, so we'll be replacing the Dark and the two Claymores. Wow. This should be nice. And hers goes up only 8, but still, it's good. Let's sell him these things. I wish we had them in categories. Like we do when we look at the equipment, but not when we go to sell. It's just an old one big list. Now I think she could use a shield as well. I think the Luna Blade is like a two-hander, so they can't have a shield. Yeah, it brings down the defense. Alright, so we'll get her the Night Shield. Which brings her up by a whole 3 points. So we want to sell that Rick shield then. Okay, good. Serene says, "The gold dust of Quitt is a blessing from Scotia. We owe all our wealth to Scotia." Okay. Is this a table? No. You're not a shop. Okay. You're not working in a shop. I know you're not a shop. You're a human being. Oh. I'm gonna talk to him last, because he's got the important thing. Over him. Actually, is that it? What's across the bridge? Lita says, "Huh? Did you come outside the village? Are you by any chance merchants who came to buy placer gold?" What's placer gold? Avon says, "No, we are adventurers. We're here to do some investigating." Investigators and adventurers. Adventurers? So, you came here to defeat the monster in the lake? The monster? Douglas says. Such a thing appears here? Mr. Oscar said he saw it when he was collecting placer gold. He said it was a very big and scary monster. Really? Says Avon. I'm sorry, but we are not here for the monster. We came here to look for a place called the Scotia Shrine. Oh yeah? I don't know where it is, but can you play with me after you're done? Huh? Says Avon. Luti says, sure, when we are done, okay? Alright! Don't forget your promise! Hey, Rutis, says Avon. Rutis says, let's take a break if we find the sacred treasure. I understand that you're still worried about your sister, but we still have a long way to go. Douglas says, Rutis is right. A first-class adventurer makes sure to get enough rest. Fortunately, this village looks very peaceful. I think it's a good place to recuperate. Says Avon. I guess you're right. Maybe we should rest for a little bit. No, we will steer the ship. Hello? Renee says, I have to do some farm work when I can't collect placer gold. I hope that somebody's going to explain what placer gold is. And is it different from regular gold? It's too much hassle. It's pretty big. Oh, I went down. I wanted to go further. Oh, we can't go further. Well, I popped down there. I don't want to go down yet. Let me look around. Can I fall down there? No. Gerald says, huh? What do you want? Do you know where the Scotia Shrine is? Well, the Scotia Shrine is in the suburbs of the village. Go to the north. To the north, Ruti says. Thanks. I try to walk places and I end up just going inside. Oh. And I keep falling down there. Oh wow, there's another screen. Alright, let's look around here first, I guess. Actually, there's nothing else. This is a big ship. The ship is bigger than the town. Okay, let's look around down here. Oscar says, are you from outside the village? Sorry, but I'm busy. I have to fix this winch device. Is that Lita again? Yeah. Mr. Oscar said he had to inspect the devices and doesn't play with me at all. Oh, look at her face. So please finish your job and play with me. Yes, we will. Eventually. Oh! Yes! I must have sold a bunch of those. As far as we were able to actually pick that up. Jumped on that boat. Is that everyone in this? I think that's everybody. I don't want to steer the ship right now. Yeah, sorry guys, just trying to be thorough here. You know me. So if we go here, it just leads back up. Yeah. Old woman Orma says, my, my, you guys don't look familiar. Are you by any chance the adventurers who came to get rid of the monster? Avon says, I'm sorry, but we are here for a different matter. We came to investigate the Scotia Shrine. Yeah, the old shrine in the suburbs. It's rare to have outsiders pay a visit there. The Scotia Shrine is north of the village. Please pay a sincere visit. By the way, guys, you look awfully tired. Why don't you come take a rest at my home? Sure. Come anytime you are tired. Don't overdo yourselves. Alright, so some people gathered up here. This is... Oh, I thought it was like another level. Alright, we're gonna go talk to these people. Henry says, should I discard this or not? I can't decide. What are you trying to discard or thinking of discarding? Robert says, during the gambling, one who shows his expression loses. You know the word poker face, don't you? Yes. So he was just discarding a playing card. That answers that question. I think that's everybody on the boat. And that goes to the shrine, I guess, over there. So, we'll talk to this guy before we go. Chief Godal says, it's rare to have a customer here. Are you from Vault? Yeah. I have some questions about Scotia, Avon says. Aha. You want to know about Scotia? Well, the moss lake that stretches south is said to have been blessed by Scotia. A lot of gold dust called the Tears of Scotia is accumulated at the bottom of the lake. However, Rutis asks, is there a problem? A huge monster appeared in the lake. That's why we can no longer go get gold. Since gold is accumulated in deep water.
Really?
We have to go to the middle of the lake by boat, dive into the water, and dredge the bottom of the lake. But once the monster appeared in the lake, Douglas says, it's certainly too dangerous to dive. So, have you come up with any solution? For the time being, we put a request to the Adventurer Guild. The shrewd adventurers should be sent to the village soon. Avon mutters, I wonder what kind of adventurer will be coming. I've put a request at the Adventurer Guild to get rid of the monster at the lake. I feel relieved now. Alright, I'm glad you feel relieved. I guess we're going to the shrine. I guess we're full of SP Arcanum 1 again. I already used it a couple times. This is a... Avon says, this looks like the old building site. Is this really the Shrine of the Spirit? It looks like it, says Douglas. But it's almost completely destroyed. I wonder if we can find the sacred treasure here. Ruti says, let's look for some clues. I wonder what this depression is. Some sentences are carved on the stone monument, but it's not readable since it's... What? Cut off. What does it say? Says Avon. Douglas says, I think it's written in sacred characters. Rutis says, the Wandering One. What? Says Avon. Can you read them, Rutis? I learned them when I was in the Octum's Apostles. I'm not that good, though. You're awesome, says Douglas. Can you read the whole thing? Okay. The Wandering One, the one who heals souls, Scotia of beautiful water, sleeps here. The Guardian built this shrine in her name and will protect it until the promised day. And this is the end. Avon says, so this is the Scotia Shrine. But Nothing's left. What on earth is going on? Douglas says, the word guardian hit me. Is he something like a caretaker of the shrine? Witi says, we better return to the village at once. There may be someone who knows more about the shrine. The wandering one, the one who heals souls, Scotia of beautiful water, sleeps here. The guardian built the shrine in her name and will protect it until the promised day. Indeed. Alright, I guess we're going back to the village. Nothing else here? I think there's gotta be an underground thing here, like this... like some kind of lift or elevator kind of... It goes down, is what I'm trying to say. It do go down! Talk to this guy. Oh, okay. He doesn't say anything new. So I'm surprised about that. Oh, these are... the shop owners aren't going to have anything to say. I guess we're going back to onto the boat. Oops. Ugh, I keep falling down. Good God. Oscar, help me out here, buddy. Can we help you fix your winch device so you can tell us about this shrine? Ugh. I can't control myself. Did you see the shrine? Avon says, yeah, but there are some things we can't figure out. Is there anyone who knows very much about the shrine? Probably the old lady. I think it's the only one I haven't talked to. Someone who knows a lot about the shrine, says Gerald. Grandma Orma might know something about the ruins. I'm sure she knows about the history of the village much better than I do. Alright. To Grandma Orma! Diddle-a-ling! Where is she again? The people playing cards over there. I guess she's further this way somewhere. Yeah. I see that question. I mean, exclamation mark over your head. Oh, hi there. Did you go check out the Scotia Shrine? Yes, we did, says Ortiz. It looks like it was built in an ancient time. Of course. It's because the shrine had existed in this village of Quitt long before the Bardis Church was established. Avon says, but does it still have meaning as a shrine after having been weathered so much? Grandma Orma says, the crumbled wreckage there is just a stone building constructed above the shrine. The true Scotia shrine is underneath it. She was right. Do you remember the place divided in squares? That's the entrance of the shrine. I wouldn't call it divided in squares, but there's definitely a depression shaped like a square. Douglas says, I remember something like that. Douglas, it was just like 2 minutes ago. How can we open the door? Well, I heard the story, but I've never actually entered it. According to the legend, there is a guardian who made a contract with Scotia, and someone in the lineage can open it. A guardian? Muti says. The stone monument mentioned a guardian, too. Is there anyone from that lineage in the village? If I'm not mistaken, the family of Serene was the same lineage of the Guardian. She lives near the village entrance. Thanks, says Avon. You're a great help. Alright, we did just see a Serene. Is it her? Oh, it's Lita. How'd you get here before us? You were on the boat. Ah, are you done with investigation? Can you play with me now? Ruti says, sorry, but not yet. Can you wait a little longer? Ugh. Okay, I will wait. So get it done quickly and play with me a lot. Alright. I'll wait, so please get it done quickly and play with me a lot. Oh, hello. How may I help you? Avon says, I heard from a villager that you are from the ancestral line of the Guardian. Is that true? It's in my family that my ancestors made a contract with Scotia. Why? Well, I was wondering if you could open the shrine's door. Avon explained to Serene why he was looking for the sacred treasures. I'm sorry, but I can't help you. I keep forgetting to change the text back from turquoise, I guess? Yeah, it should be like white again now. I've heard that my ancestors were guarding the shrine, but that was 100 years ago. Neither my father nor my grandfather had the power as a guardian. I don't either, since I don't know much about the shrine. He's still with the blue text. Oh, so Avon says. Ruti says, we have no choice but to ask others. I'm sorry that I can't help you. I'll do my best to help you. I'm sorry I wasn't much help today. You have to ask others. Alright, let's ask this guy in here. Okay. Nothing new there. So it's really just... two shop owners. We've got two, now three NPCs in town. And some people on the boat, so I have to ask them. I'd better prepare my boat soon. It's too much hustle. Everything's too much hustle for you. Is this guy done with his winch yet? Maybe he'll help us out. His winch device. Oh, here we go. Well, I better start getting the Scotia ready. I gotta hurry, because it's almost time. I guess the boats go to Scotia, too. For what? Says Avon. As a matter of fact, says Oscar, an adventurer who is hired by the chief is going to arrive at the village. Douglas says, I remember the chief saying something like that. There was a monster in Moss Lake, right? Right. That's why he put a request to the guild to get rid of the monster. I'm glad that the Adventurer Guild responded so quickly. If things continue to go on this way, it'll be horrible. Alright. Who is it, girl? It's SP Arcanum 1. I spit on that. How was it? We heard an interesting story, says Avon. Good for you. The monster has been appearing in Moss Lake. Since it's dangerous, we are so bored because we can't sail in a boat. Chief was saying that he was going to hire a skilled adventurer, but I can hardly wait for him to come. You leave your stinking rarer potion. Talk to the old lady again. We're supposed to, like, ask other people stuff, so... Serena's a good girl. She looks after her sister, Lita, very well, too. It's about time to help her find someone. Well, we don't care about that right now. Require information. I lost again, says Henry. If the game involves roses, I don't feel good after the game. Maybe it's time for me to get ready with the Scotia. This guy is not so good at card games, but he can't stop gambling with roses. In the first place, trying to make easy money is too optimistic. I have to teach him a lesson about that. And what about secondly? Alright. That's it. Oh. The voice says, "Ah, you are? Who's that?" Oh, Lucius? Douglas says Lucius? Even says, and Jimmy. Jimmy says, "Yo, what's up, guys? Nice seeing you again." Lucius says, "I have the worst luck. Why do I keep running into you no matter where I go?" Douglas says, "Do you really mean that? You know you really came here just to see me?" Lucius says, "I admire your self-confidence. But you better shut up if you don't want me to cut you like a bonsai tree." Lucius slightly narrowed her eyes. Just slightly. Douglas says, "Okay, okay, I'm sorry." Avon says, "You're such a pig, Douglas, with your rude and inappropriate jokes." Hootie says, "How come you guys are here, Lucius?" "I heard the news about the huge monster appearing in Moss Lake." "Oh, so you're the adventurers that were sent." "So I was hired to get rid of it." "I see. You were the one who was hired," says Avon. "But how come Jimmy's here? Does he join the Adventurer Guild?" "Because he needs someone to watch him constantly, so I decided to keep an eye on him." Jimmy says, "Lucius worries too much. Do you think a good boy like me would do anything wrong?" "Do you think so, Douglas?" "Well, it's important to have trust in people. I was also wrongly suspected a lot when Lucius and I were training together." "Wow, poor Douglas," says Jimmy. Lucius says, "Fine, gang up on me if you want. I really don't care." "Where are you going?" "I'm going to go talk with Village Chief. Jimmy, you stay here. Don't move." I know. Gee, Lucius is too bossy. Why can't she just leave me alone? Haha, says Rutiz. She's just worried about you. But she is always nagging. Then if I do anything, she gets mad like crazy, too. She can't spoil you. Lucius knows what's best for you. I think she's a very warm and good person. Douglas says, "Well, that's because she's my proud sister disciple. But I think she could go a little easier on him." Avon says, "So, Douglas, why doesn't Lucius like you? I can't quite figure you guys out." "That's a..." Girl's voice says, "Ah, hello there." "It's old home week." Oh, it's Lita. "Are you done with your work? Can you play with me yet?" Avon says, "Sorry, but we are not done yet." Huh? "I've never seen you before." Jimmy says, "I bet. I just got here. Do you want to play with me?" "Play with you? Are you kidding me? I don't have time to play with a little kid." "What are you talking about?" says Avon. "You're a little kid too." "Shut up. I've been living on my own for a long time. I'm mentally mature." Lita says, so you don't want to play with me? I hate when kids won't stop bothering me. Ugh, says Lita. Lita looks like she's about to cry. Wow! Okay, so now she is crying. Hey, says Jimmy. Wah! Douglas says, look, you made her cry. Mutu says, I can't believe you made a girl cry. Avon says, you are not even fit to be a man. Low blow. Wait a minute. Oh, please stop crying. You're making me look bad. Okay, okay. I'll play with you. Really? Ugh. What a mercenary kid. Ugh. Alright, alright. I'll play with you as much as you want. Yeah! Okay, let's play over there. That's a good place to play hide and seek. Hide and seek? So, you know, I'm invincible as far as hide and seek is concerned. I'm good too, Lita says. When I made my sister mad, I hid from her all day without being found. Let's have a match, says Jimmy. Yeah! Avon says, ha ha ha, he is still such a little kid. Ruti says, I think he's a good kid, just had some bad times. Douglas says, yep, the best thing about children is their innocence. Okay. Well, we're gonna crack this shrine yet, guys. I'm gonna call an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always, seek adventure. And rare potion, thank you.